Yeah, okay. Hello, my name is Antje Radke, and today I want to talk about Wine Point 6 and the output and what will be happen to the templates. First, my English isn't very well, so if anybody can't understand what I'm trying to say, please interrupt me. The chance that I'm wrong is very high. So, my first question is, how many developers we have? Okay, and how many people already installed 1.6? Okay, so then we can start. Can everybody see this? The bad news at the beginning, all templates will break more or less. Here can you see two examples. One is the bees after installing 1.6 with the sample data. And the other one is one of a big template club. You can see the bees, it looks not so much worse, only a little bit styling is missing. And the other one is totally broken. It looks more broken than it really is, because it's using some functionalities of a Joomla framework, and these functionalities are changed, so it will break. To fix it is not so much work than it looks at the beginning. But why break these templates? These templates break because the HTML output is changed and the class names of the Joomla output are changed. And we add some new views and functions on the framework are changed. Let's have a look at the history. We have 1.0. Everybody knows 1.0, huh? Yeah, okay. In 1.0, we have no possibility to modify the HTML output. That was a mess for all the template designers. And at that time, Robert and me, we do this core hack, but hacking the core isn't a good solution because it's a big security issue and you can't update your Joomla installation anymore. Yeah? In 1.5, we had the same output we had before in 1.0, but at that moment we had this template overrides, and so the designers and template developers are able to change the output. And in that version, this was demonstrated by the ugly purple bees template. Yeah? And the bees template was only developed for how to demonstrate how this template overrides are worked. It was never built for using it like it is. Yeah? And my idea was that many other template developers will pick up the idea of bees and use it and make some open source templates by their own. But I never see much of them. Yeah? This is a pity. And in 1.6, we will say goodbye to the table output and want to do the core output tableless. And then we will have bees 2.0, and this will demonstrate how the HTML5 output works. Our goals were more aligned with the web standards. Yeah? We want a separation between content and layout, and we will say goodbye to the table layout. Yeah? And here's some important to say that tables are not worse by itself. If they present a data structure, they are okay and the best way to use. They are only bad if you want to use it for the layout. And then we want to use a logical semantic structure. We want to use headlines where they are necessary, paragraphs, lists, definition lists, and somewhere else, yeah, to make it more accessible, yeah. Then we try to use understandable class names, yeah. This is very important. If you want to figure out, if you want to change something in your template, yeah, you have many times to look, where should I do this, and we decided to name the classes like it's works. You understand what I mean? Yeah, okay. And on the other hand, we need a lot of time to put the classes on the right places, yeah? Because you need the possibility to style everything you want. So we have to add a lot of classes at every places. And all the standard lovers of you will say, oh, they have so much classes, we don't need them all because I use normally context selectors or something else. But on the other hand, it's very easy to remove the classes in your own template overrides than to add them when you don't know where you should add them. Yeah? And on and last but not least, we have some more views, and all these views have got new parameters, and then I add it. Is there dieses Ding davor? Oh. Can everybody see that what was stand there? Because there is this window. Back. Okay, one example for the new views, this is the nested cats. Everybody knows that we have in 1.5 not the possibility to nest the categories inside each other. We have this section and category model, and we say goodbye to this, and now we have only categories which can be nested in each other. And to display this, we have a new view. And here's an example. You can see there is some text. This is a block view of a category. And underneath, you got the possibility to display the subcategories. And the subcategories, you can choose that you can display the articles, how much articles should are inside these categories. Yeah. And here you can see the parameters in the menu item. Yeah, I think if most of the people installed it already, you will know that. Huh? Yeah, and all these possibilities make it necessary that we have these new views, and we have to style these new views. And the old templates don't know anything about these views because they're new. Yeah, but what should I do? Yeah. The first thing you can do is to discover the new functionalities. Yeah, to install Joomla 1.6, to make experiments, click and try to build your new website with 1.6. And on the other hand, you can inspect the new HTML code we have now. Inspect the code. You can look at this page source, yeah, if you choose it in your browser, but this is not so much comfortable, yeah, but you can inspect the code with the Firebug. I think everybody knows what Firebug is. Okay, yeah, and you have the possibility to discover the Joomla code by yourself. And here you can see the Joomla structure. Everybody looks at it already? No? Okay, after installation, you can see the file structure on the left, and then you have the components, and inside the components, you have the component com content, and the com content is display all these article and categories, and inside the com content, you have the views, all the different views you can choose by the menu, and here, for example, you have this featured view. This featured view is the same thing we have formerly called front page view. It is renamed now. I should back. No, no, yeah. No, no, you have maybe here, for example, the featured, and then in the featured you have the temple folder, and there are the views in, and then you have a default one, yeah. Here you can see it, what I mean, yeah. So, and you can see in the line, this is the first beginning of the default default view. And if you're on this, you can inspect it by yourself, yeah? You can try out what happens there, yeah? And what you can use for the template overrides. Now the question is, what should I do with my template? Yeah? you can handle it conservatively. Yeah, that means you can fix the template you have, that it will work like before. Yeah, the question is, is it good? It works then, but you have the old code, and you can't have the advantage of the new code then. Yeah. But you can fix it easy. And when I was on the Dutch Joomla Day, I first thought that the most of the people will be angry that they have to work so much at the templates. But the people told me that it is a chance to get much more money, because all the customers will be updated. So it should be not so bad. And here you can see the structure of the Milky Way template. We have it already. Yeah, and inside the Milky Way template, we have a folder underline HTML. And in this underline HTML folder, we will have the old views with the same class names than before. But this is not already been done. If maybe someone is interested, he can do that. But our aim is to have in this folder the old views and with the old class names. Why? Yeah, because maybe a lot of people will think we will need it, yeah, because they don't want to update the templates. So it's an easy solution for them. They can copy the HTML folder into their template and it will work. Yeah, I think it is the easiest way. Yeah. But I think it isn't a good solution, but it is a solution. Yeah, it depends on how much, yeah? Yes, we do. Yes, we do. Yeah, yeah, but we need, we add the same class names than before, yeah, this component heading and something like that. Yeah, and the template needs these classes to don't be a break, yeah? But if someone is interested in doing this, we will be lucky if somebody will help us. Nobody, I see. Okay. If somebody used the HTML 1.5b's HTML code already, he has not much problems. Did somebody use them? Okay. The structure of the 1.6 output is more or less the same than in the B's template. Only the class names are changed. So you don't have to do so much. You only need a little bit cosmetic, yeah? You only need to rename the CSS classes. In the CSS files, and then you have to add the new CSS for the new views, yeah, because they haven't been there already, yeah. And if you are a template doctor, or you want to be one, you can do an implant. You can build your new B's template. In 1.6, we will have two B's templates. We decided this the day before today, yesterday. How you call it, the day before yesterday? So one with what? Okay. One with the possibility of having HTML5 or XHTML. And one without having HTML5. So you can take a look at that, and you can learn from that, like you did in 1.0. And the B's template is much more than HTML5. I add a lot of accessibility features to the B's template. One of them is to adding YArea. Everybody knows what it is? YArea is a new technology that makes it possible to build little web applications or widgets accessible for screen reader users, for example. Yeah? if you install the Beast template, you have the possibility to choose the different styles of the modules. There's a one module, Chrome, that is called Beast Hide. Yeah, then the module is output is comes out of a slider. Yeah, first there you only have the headline, and there's a little cross over there, and so you can click on the cross, and the module will comes out. Yeah, and on the other hand we have this accessible tabs. Yeah, and to learn about this, so it is easy to inspect it with a firebug to see what happens there. Yeah, and I add Y area roles. Everybody knows what this is? Y area roles? Nobody? Okay, area roles. They describe the functionality of part of the templates. Maybe one role is navigation, for example. Yeah, or main content, or additional information. So all the screen reader users will already know when they open the site where what is positioned. Yeah, and all the tabs they can see if they are open or closed. Yeah, it's very comfortable. And for all of the developers of us, it's very important to take a look of this Y area because it makes it more usable for disabled people. So, and now I'm at the end, and I'm very fast. And I hope everybody of you have got a lot of questions. Don't be angry, yeah? First I thought most of the people will be angry because so much has changed, but I see nobody's angry, so I'm very happy about this. And I hope now you have a lot of questions because I was fast. Somebody wants to see how the tabs are working? Okay, then I think I need a little bit of time. When is the next presentation here? Somebody knows? Ah, okay, so I have enough time. Oh, I have many 1.6 versions here on my laptop. I hope I can find one working. Maybe that one. Okay, here you can see the different styles of the Beast template, for one for the park side, one for the fruit shop, and the default one. And you can set the modules. Did everybody of you take a look at the positions already? No? Yes or no? No, in 1.5 we had this position left, right, top, and something like that. And now we have decided to use generic positions, like position 1, position 2, 3, 4, 5, till 15, I think. This is necessary because everybody wants to put the modules on different positions, and then left is not anymore left anymore, or right is not right anymore, or bottom isn't bottom anymore. So we decided to use generic names. Yeah? Yes. Yeah, you can change it in your in your XML file, or, yeah, like it was before. Yeah, and you should do this. Yeah? But this template is for the sample data and to use for everybody. So we use these generic names. Yeah, but I think the best way is if you have a real project, then change it to top left, right, main navigation, whatever. Yeah, so that it makes sense for the users and for the writers. Yeah. Here you can see all these positions, and now I choose, let me remember, position 5. I hope it was the right one. Yes, here you can see these tabs. Ah, the Beamer is, it's only one module inside, yeah? And if you inspect it with the Firebug, yeah, you can see these Y areas. Can you see this? Yeah? Okay. Yeah? Then you can see that the mod login area is selected gleich to selected true. Yeah? And all this stuff is not is written with JS into the site because this is a standard which is not can be used already. It's not verabschiedet. Everybody can help me. What means verabschiedet? No? Not released, yeah. Already. So I put this with JS into the site. On the other hand, if I don't do this, it will be that the validator can't work with it already. This is the tab thing. And now we can choose to the slide thing. 6. No, 6 was wrong. Maybe 4. Yeah, here. And you can click here, and it goes like that. And both of these solutions are accessible, and that thing is an important thing. Most of the people, they like a lot of this JS stuff, but this JS stuff, it's possible to make it accessible. It's no problem. Yeah, it depends on where the focus is. Everybody knows what I mean? Yeah? So it's no problem to make it accessible. Yeah, and on the other hand, we have you can open or close the third column. You have see this? If you put something on the right side, there is a little cross, and you can the user can close the right column by itself, and this is also accessible. Because I do it inside, because most of the times you have a lot of content inside a site, if you have a big site, and so the people, they can choose by themselves what content they want to already see, yeah? Mm-hmm.
Can we still add a module position without editing the XML file via the backend?
No, you have to change the XML.
Yeah, because file. In 1.5 we could add a position without editing the XML file.
Oh.
Yeah, of course. I if If you click on the module position and you write whatever one name in 1.5 was added automatically. No? Some editors don't know how to edit XML files, yes?
Yeah.
And in the backend, before it was possible just to enter a name, click enter and save, and the position was saved.
Yeah.
No, it's no more possible. Oh, you don't know. Okay.
Thank you.
Some more questions? No, it isn't possible. Yeah. Yeah? I never try it out. Maybe you know more than me. Das dann auch geht, du. Ehrlich gesagt, das weiß ich nicht. Ja? Ich weiß es nicht. I don't know. Muss man answer. Ja?
So it seems that the module position changes are much bigger impact than the class names. For the templating, redoing your templates, and that's not going to be handled by overrides at all, right?
No.
Some more? No, okay. Yeah, the class names are named like the thing it is. Yeah, maybe it's a, if you you have the links in the block view, yeah, it's called items more. And we every time we will use the hyphen between all the class names. The semantic structure you mean, yeah? It's the same like in bees, yeah? The H1 is this headline you use in the menu, and the main content has H2, and the headline of the subcategories has H3. No, it's the system itself. And you can use the overrides that, like you know in 1.5, yeah? It's the same one. And in the Beast 5, I use HTML5. I think it could be very interested, yeah? And HTML5, I like it very much because it's had a lot of new semantic stuff inside. And the best thing of the HTML5 is the doc type. The doc type is called HTML, yeah, doc type HTML, and that's it, yeah. And this is really great because I never mention the doc type. I always copy it from another template, so that's very funny. It's very easy now, yeah. And you have a lot of more stuff. You have a thing like called sections, articles, headers, footers, aside. Yeah, and it's really great. Yeah, you can take a look at the Beast template, and you will see this, and it's very, very easy. Yeah, but if you use HTML5 output of the Beast template, you should know that it is not working in Internet Explorer 6. Stop! If JS is disabled, if JS is enabled, it works fine because I write the missing tags on the runtime into the DOM. And I think the future is in HTML5, yeah? And the normal validator now, since 6 weeks, he validates HTML5 sites. And this is a situation now, we know it's, the developing of HTML5 is going very fast, and the group around Ian Hixon, they did a very great job, yeah? And now HTML2 is dead, I think everybody knows this. Yeah, and the group about Ian Hixon, they have done a very, very great work, I think, yeah. But we have to be careful with some tags. They are not supported of any browsers and of the Internet Explorer 8. Yeah, it's like Canvas or something like that. I only put this tags inside which are supported, yeah. What are you using? I'm using the browsers, and many time. Yes, I use a Mac, and I do a lot of tests. But the Beez template isn't finished yet. Yeah, and if somebody can help test, makes tests, I will be very, very lucky. And you can write all the problems that we have in the bug tracker. That would be great. Yeah, in 1.6 we have this new backend template from Andrea Tarr. Maybe a lot of people will see this. And Andrea did a very great job, yeah, because she wants to do the backend template accessible. And I think she did it very well. But there are some problems still there, but it is not on Andrea's fault. It's a fault on the framework. But I think it's a good step in the right direction now, yeah? And I think it's changed slowly, and we need a little bit more time to make it perfect, yeah? What? Yeah, in the back end, you mean? Yeah. And if you use this thing from your browser, it doesn't work? Yeah, but I think you can choose this font sizer in your browser. But it's very hard for the designer to put all this stuff in this small place, yeah, we have, so it's very difficult, yeah.
Sorry. If you use translation, I'm translating already 1.6. We have longer words, like a username is a much bigger word in Dutch. So I noticed already there's not room enough. Do you also test with translations?
I think there is the same problem with the German language. Yeah, yeah. The English language has only always very short words, and they do some tests. Jean-Marie did, I think. Yeah, and I'm not sure. The French language is a bit longer too. So I think he did the tests. Some more? Yeah, so I think with 1.6 and the Beez template, there's a possibility to make the templates easy. Yeah, because there are three CSS files, three important ones. One is the layout, one is the position, and one is for the styling. Yeah, and if you install it, you can figure it out and take a look at the CSS files, and then you can see that the position and the layout files, the position is for the positioning of the things, and the layout is for all these margins and paddings and something like that. And the third one is only for the styling, yeah, for the colors and something like that. So it's more easy to change the color and something like that. And what I don't explain, the Beast template you can choose after installation if you have the navigation on the left or on the right side per default. Yeah, this is very necessary for sometimes for the search engines. Yeah, if you have the navigation after the content, and it depends on what the designer will have and how should it look like. Yeah, and so it's very easy. You can change you can change the position of the navigation before or after content, and the styling shows you right or left. And you can choose a logo through the parameters. You don't have to go into the index.php anymore. Now we have the parameters in the database. Why? Yeah, because they are earlier in way available then. What? Oh, it's very easy. Yeah, now you have the possibility in the backend on the templates to copy the template and have your own style. You know what I mean? Frag's in Deutsch. Yeah, that is possible. No problem. Bees works like that. Yeah, you have different styles here. Yeah, it's no problem. Bees is working like that. And this is one of the this is what I described before. You have this layout and you have this position and then you have the style. And you can have a lot of styles. No, 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 no. Yeah, you can take a look here. We have here the different styles. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah, these are in the XML data. Yeah, we have this in the XML date file. Some more questions? Yes. The structure of the XML files changed too, because the forms changed. Okay, you can see. Yeah, we changed these params two fields. Yeah, and here you can see all this language stuff, yeah? Went too fast. Okay. What? Yes. Yeah, we are working on that, I think. Yeah. Does everybody knows what the module Chrome is? Yeah. Okay. Yeah, you can do it all in the overrides, yeah? You have been working already with the overrides? Yeah. What? Oh, that's it? Okay, then I'm finished.